We're in it now. We're in the juice and the drama. And I am terrified. Hello, welcome to the video. I'm Melissa. I write books. We're writing one today. I feel like a lot of my recent videos, maybe I write for 25 minutes. I don't want to place the sense of like, you can only be a real writer if you're writing 100 million words every day. That's not my intention. And I have actually been making really steady progress in gas station, but what always happens, I say this as if it's happened more than once, but I do remember this from the last time I started querying and then started writing a new book directly after that. Every time I get any sort of anything related to querying, it derails me for like a day. Even if it's like a form rejection or a message or like I see some random thing about like, oh, you can submit here if you have a book that's ready to be queried. And I'm like, so I feel like the last few weeks have honestly been a lot of like random querying things. So I'll write like during my live streams, which have been life-saving. But today, what you're here for is a 12-hour writing challenge. I'm not gonna write for 12 hours straight because I don't know if that's humanly possible. Actually, it is. I've done it a few, like maybe once, and it was not in an intentional way. It was not like I planned to write for 12 hours. It was just like the part of the process I was in needed to focus, and I just like went into a zone. I'm just gonna essentially try to write once every hour, at least once every hour. I'm in the 8 a.m. window right now. So at 9 a.m., I'll tell you how many words I wrote from 8 to 9. You know, that kind of thing. So I'll hopefully check in every hour. I do plan to go to like maybe a coffee shop or something. I decided to do this like 5 minutes ago. So I haven't really thought it all through yet, but I am right up to the midpoint of this book. And the midpoint is like 4 chapters long. And I would really like to get through or like do a lot of that in one kind of sitting or chunk or day or something, like with not within a few weeks, within a few days, you know, just because I want to see how it flows and how it feels. Again, I'm on chapter 12 right now. There's 29 chapters in the book, so it's really not halfway through, but I think the midpoint is chapters like 13 through 17. Like, I think it's a big, well, actually I know. It's a big event happening and it's a dual POV. So you're getting it from both angles and the drama, the drama. So that's kind of my plan. It's like 8:40 right now. So the first hour I will probably get like 100 words or something. Let me tell you about this book that I'm writing. Cause I feel like the last few vlogs I've just been like, let me fold my laundry for 5 hours and talk about a book that is already done. I'm writing, it's an adult thriller, it's a dual POV, it's a very heavy romance, not anything spicy, just a lot of yearning. Essentially, it's more heart than crime. But, okay, well, if I'm gonna write it all during the 8 a.m. hour, I better get cooking. Everybody, it's 9 a.m. It's been about 12 minutes and I think I got about 400 words. So total for the day, 400. That's pretty good for 10 minutes. To remind you, I know I can be a bit of a broken record sometimes. These are not fresh words. These are words coming from already written words, but the already written words are a mess of dictation. I'm just gonna give you an example actually, because I think that will help illustrate. Here's the original sentence. From the dictation. Calvary's is his eyebrows between us, seeing the rising tension on my face. I got it, whispers. Have a seat. Will you go in? He asks in a voice that is kind and firm. No punctuation, nothing. So that translates to, Cal raises his eyebrows, sensing the rising tension between us. I got it, he says. Let's sit down. So you see, like, the original sentence is there. And as the person who originally said that, I know what's happening in the scene, so I can transcribe it. And I do end up changing a lot. Like, in this scene especially, I ended up kind of writing stuff that I didn't even take from the old draft. I was just like, I just kind of want to write a little bit in this scene and then go back to what's there and like flesh it out a little bit. So it's a mix, but I did get about 400 words. I'll check in with you again at 10. About 600? Yeah. So eight hundred words. I can't do math, clearly. And then I fell down a rabbit hole of watching TV show and movie trailers, and then I got stressed about the world. So probably gonna take a little break from being sitting in this chair, and then maybe come back and do like another 15 minutes at the end of this hour. It's like 11:30, so let me update you on two things. So I didn't start writing until 10:50 because YouTube is a vortex of attention. So it was fine. I ended up writing 200 words in the last 10 minutes of the hour, and then it's 11:30 and I've written 1100 words. Is that right? Yes. 1100 words. And I finished that scene I was on. Yeah, now we're at the midpoint. Now we're really in it. There's a lot of logistics in the midpoint and it's a little stressful. So I'm gonna eat some food and then I will be back to conquer the midpoint. I don't know how many words this is for the day. I'll have to do math later. So I only have 6 minutes left of the hour. So let's see how many we can do. It's 1 p.m. Yikes. Well, for writing for 6 minutes, I did get 150 words. The weather is really being misleading. I don't know when I'm gonna go on my run. I wanna go to a coffee shop and write. So I'm gonna go to a chain because I feel like chains are open, which is maybe I shouldn't be supporting that they're open on a day off. I'm gonna drive to one real quick, but the writing is, those 100 words were pretty fire. They actually were. I'm kind of slaying the game, if I do say so myself. Maybe I could call. Who am I calling people? Hi there, I was just calling to see what hours you guys are open today.
Oh, we're open till.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure because it was Memorial Day, so.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, thank you. They're open all day, which is kind of sad for society, but happy for me. Okay, everyone, change of plans. Going on a run. I'm still continuing on the challenge. I'm gonna write one sentence in this hour and then I'll come back. And that should be before three. So. All right, I wrote 15 words. I'll see you in the next hour. Hi everyone, if you can't tell, I went on my run. It was actually a 5K. I mean, we watched some of it, but We drove to where the 5K is happening and then did the route. And I'm sweating. And I come bearing unfortunate news, and that it is 3:07. So I did not write any words in the 2 o'clock hour, unfortunately. And I really didn't in the 1 o'clock hour either. But we still have the 3 o'clock hour, the 4 o'clock hour, 5, 6, 7, 8. 6 hours left of the challenge. That's a lot of hours. And I'm gonna be, it's 3:08, but I'm gonna shower. You could probably smell me through the screen. And then I think I'm gonna go to a coffee shop. Depends on the time. I might have to do, if it's too close to 4, I might do my 3 o'clock stuff here. Or I'll go to the coffee shop and then write. I kind of want to stay there for a while. For sure get 2 hours in there. But the run was good. My head feels clearer. I was really falling down a bad rabbit hole of watching YouTube clips of a show. Okay, does anybody else work like this? Okay. I will get really addicted to television shows. Television shows, am I 45? And the way that it always starts is I'll see a TikTok, or I'll see a little video, or I'll see a commercial, and I'll be like, I'm just gonna look up TV show reunion. Like, I'll be like, ooh, Castle reunions. And then I'll like look up clips, or like best clips of this show. So I do fully spoil the show for myself. And then I'm like, well, maybe I should just watch one episode. And then no one sees me for 3 weeks. So I'm trying to avoid that. And I almost fell down a rabbit. I was almost started watching a show, but I'm not gonna do it. And now we're in the big scary midpoint where there's so much drama, but there's also a lot of logistics. And I remember being stressed about the logistics because it's a lot of things that like, would this really happen in real life? No. And I might actually need to do more research, but I can't decide if I'm actually gonna do the research now, or if I'm gonna write, like, do research on this and then have that be a part of my revision. Because I don't think it's something that would really change that much of the book. It would just change, like, how something happens. It's a lot of, like, police response to things. Like, how would the police actually respond to something like this? But I also have watched a lot of crime TV, and so I'm kind of like, maybe I just kind of vibe. Hello, it is 3:37, so I'm gonna quick write for 10 minutes. I'm just telling you now, the hours of 4, 5, and 6 are gonna be much heavier on the writing, okay? She says, hopefully. Hi, the lighting is bad, but this is a horrible angle for me. Now there's a car pulling up behind me. I think I ended up writing for about 30 minutes into the hour of 5. I got about 900 words in between 4 and 5, and then I think I did around 800 or 900 between 5 and 6, and I just really was getting into the meat, the potatoes, the chicken salad of it all. But I had to pee, but then I didn't want to leave all my stuff unattended next to this man. There was this other man, and I was just like, you know what? Once I get into this, I feel like I'm not going to want to stop, and my wrists were starting to hurt. I have a lot of reasons why I left this coffee shop, apparently. But, so I want my ergonomic keyboard. It's 5:54, so I'm going to start in the 6th hour, and I think I might just, like, I don't know how many words it is, but there's this whole situation that happens. I think we go back and forth in POV twice, so I think it's probably like 4 chapters equivalent. There's no way I'm gonna write 4 chapters tonight, but like, I just wanna kinda zip my zippity-doo-dah my way through that. But the challenge is going very well. I'm not even feeling burnt out, so that's good and exciting for me. Okay, so now we're at 7. I need about 500 words. Let's keep going. Hi everyone, it's 8 p.m. You guys, I'm already reaching the end of this candle. And the end of my battery, yeah, you guys. Okay, one second. Let's do some math, shall we? Okay, 175, 884. All right, I'm remembering about this midpoint that I don't really love to write it right before I go to bed. Kind of stresses me out, actually. And yes, it does all come from my imagination. I don't know if this math sounds correct to you, but I did write 4,868 words today, which is definitely more than I've been writing before this. I feel like I wrote more than that, but I didn't. I'm right in the mid of the midpoint, right in the middle. And again, I think I'm gonna end it here. I think I did write one word in the hour between 8 and 9, so. Did legally write from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Did I really? No. But challenges are just about making you write a little bit more than you would have otherwise. So that makes it a success in my book, but we're in it now. We're in the juice and the drama. I feel good about it. Have added like 4 chapters. I'm like exactly halfway through. Actually, because chapter 14 out of 28. I'm gonna stop talking now. Comment down below a timer emoji. Do those exist? Let me know in the comments down below. Have you ever tried to write every hour? Because it was, I don't know if I was really very successful, especially around the 2-3 clock hour of the day, but it was nice to like kind of check in with the project throughout the day and kind of like always be thinking about it. And even if I just wrote like one sentence to check in and remind myself where I'm at and immerse myself in the writing, it was a good day. I feel like I made a lot of progress, but we all know what comes after the midpoint, and it is Act 2, Part 2, and I am terrified. But if I recall, I think this Act 2, Part 2 is a little bit better. She says, hoping, wishing, praying on a star that this is true. Because, yikes. But I know some of my favorite scenes of the book are coming up, and then the ending. It's a bing, bang, boom, bada, boop, bop ending. So I am excited to continue writing this book. So thanks for joining me today. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.